Well, here we are in a third installation of the custom snare build. Now, where I left off at, I had already gone ahead and lacquered this whole thing. Now, I decided to use lacquer because lacquer is a much harder finish and it'll last a lot longer. What I've already done is I've gone and wet sanded this. I didn't want to sit here and show you wet sanding because it's pretty boring. All you do is spray bottle and use wet sandpaper. And I started at 600. Up to 800 and then went to 1,000, and now I'm going to start on this particular one with 1500. This is the last one, and then I will go to what is called rottenstone. And again, sanding's no big deal, but I've decided to do this hand sanding, and you just squirt and that's it. And you want to keep sanding until it gets nice and smooth like glass. You'll feel the sandpaper start to catch a little bit on wet sand. And every now and then you'll have to take a rag or a towel and wipe off each section. I basically go in between the lugs and go two or three times back and forth. And as I said, I've got a thick enough level, thick enough layer of lacquer on here. I don't have to worry about going through it. Again, I'm just going back and forth with just slight pressure here. I'm not really pushing down. If you push down, you get scritches and scratches and all kinds of other stuff in there, and you really don't want that. We've worked too hard to get to this level. And just let the grit and the sandpaper do what it does. This is the exciting part, as you can tell. Kind of like in Castaway. You wouldn't happen to have a match. That's looking awesome. So I think I'm going to stop right there. I don't see. That just looks flat. Oh, that's beautiful. And you can really start seeing the grain really starts coming out. So squirt, squirt. Seven more of these. Okay, this is the next to last step on finishing. The first thing we're going to do is I'm going to use something called rottenstone. And this is a, you can get any kind of rottenstone, but it's basically pumice. So I've got me some water here. I've got a wet microfiber. You can use any towel or cloth you want. And you just dump a little bit in here like that. And this does get messy. So you have clothes on, you're good being messy with. So we just take a little bit of this, and I'm going to start the same way I did this here, moving around the same way, and this is what you do, and this really polishes everything up. Again, it's a lot more really fine sanding. Again, is really what it is, except having sandpaper, you have this rottenstone. And this is another one. Again, once this is done, it'll look like a dang mirror. You can see when you're done sanding, sometimes you have some areas that are kind of, well, they look, I don't know, they look dull. And when this is done, you don't have any dull spots because basically this goes down in the nooks and crannies and it really does polish. And once you start seeing this, you really start seeing the grain come out. It's something to really see as you do this. What happens to the finish? It just gets better and better and better. And this doesn't take a whole lot. This one, you know, you don't have to sit there and sand and look. You basically make a pass over it and you're pretty much done with this. This is rubbing out all the scratches from the 1500. So it is going to be absolutely mirror finish when we put the paste wax on, which is the next step. Oh, yeah. The difference between that and the 1500 is just absolutely incredible. It is just smooth as glass now. And the grain is just popping. You can sit here and if you look close, you can see the little rays of the grain in there. And it's just so. Again, this is why we have wood grunts. So. That grain just keeps coming out. Just keeps coming out. It's just so. It is so rewarding to see this. And it is just absolutely, as I said, it is awesome to see this. It's just, it's a whole another level when you get here. Well, here's the last bit in finishing. And I'm just going to rub this stuff on and then you'll see it later when I assemble it. But it's just basically, you take, I'm using paste wax. And again, paste wax can be messy and nasty. So all you're doing, all you're trying to do is get a nice, good coat on there. And you'll be able to see it by the sheen will go away and it will get kind of rough. But this will have to dry for about, 15 minutes. I'm going to let it dry an hour. The longer you let it dry, the better the wax is going to be. And again, as I said, it can be a mess. This particular rag just lives in the wax can. That way I can just pull it out whenever I need it. So. And again, this is, you're just trying to get a good coat over everything. And, you know, this is what they call hand rubbed. I'm trying to coat the whole bit. And I'll probably take like two laps around this to make sure, again, everything's just rubbed in there really good. And then just let it set, just like a car wax. And, next time you see this particular shell, it's going to be gleaming, and I'll start putting on the lugs and all the other accoutrements and a lot of snare drum pretty soon. This is going to turn into a beautiful thing pretty quickly. It'll be worth all the particular work I put into it. Here we are on a second lap, so to speak. It really is bringing out the grain. It's just absolutely. If you can see this up close, you'd be amazed at it. There we go. Now I'm going to go around the bearing edges with this wax. And that is it. All I gotta do is leave it dry and wipe it off. Probably about an hour, maybe two. I might even leave it overnight. The better this sets up, it'll come off pretty difficult, but it will absolutely make a better, harder finish. So this, as I said, should last quite a long time. So that's the end of finishing. We'll be assembling next. Well, welcome back. Here we are on part three of the snare build, the custom snare build, and here it is, finally finished, and I'm very pleased with it. Now, some of the features on it, it's just got a regular pearl throw-off and a pearl snare butt. The finish is just natural maple lacquer over sanding sealer. It's got probably eight coats, and then as I showed, I buffed it out. I sanded it from 400 all the way up to 1500. And then I used rottenstone on the outside and then a Johnson's paste wax on the outside. The top and bottom of the rims are S-hoops. These are folded over So some people like them, some people don't. I tend to think that when you do this, you have a more, that gets you a better rim shot than the other one. Also, I put Allen head lug screws all the way around. So these things tend to stay, I don't know if it's the threads, but they tend to stay a lot better on the on tuning. Now, this is with the sonar. The sonar takes a slotted, you have to use a screwdriver on it. But this all started with this crazy build here, this Pearl 14 by 10 inch fiberglass snare. And again, it's very, very wet, very deep. And then you go to this one, which I think is perfect. And you go to this one here, and this is a beast. So this one tends to have a little bit more in voicing, and I am very pleased about how this one came out. So as you can see at the, this is a sonar snare stand that I have this one on. So sonars tend to go down a little lower. This is a Pearl stand. So as you can see, it's about the same height almost all the way down. So this is, again, I think this is a perfect snare. The 12 ply rosewood Sonor Phonic. It's a very good snare. But this one, yes, I'm partial to it. And this thing looks pretty nice with all the die cast coffin lugs from Pearl. I think it's got a really good sexy look to it. It looks pretty good. I did put a Pure Sound snare on here. And yes, I made those from drum heads, so I did the drum head hack. Again, all in all, I'm pleased with this. So again, spare parts, not bad for spare parts other than the hoops and the Allen head wrenches, Allen head lugs. So there you go. Go out and build something and you might be surprised. So anyway, hopefully when I get all my licks back up together, I'll start showing you in the other videos some of my other drum sets. So my next video is going to be Pearl drums, just all the drum sets that I have and I've rebuilt over the years. And just to show you those, no, I'm not going to be playing them. As I said, I'm just getting back into this. So anyway, but I'm going to be working on it. So till later. Farewell.